गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स कंटिन्यू अवर टॉपिक। नाउ टुडे विल स्टार्ट इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंसेस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंस मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट इन एग्जामिनेशन। मोस्टली इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंस कम इन योर एग्जाम, सो यू ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड। आई एम जस्ट गिविंग वन एग्जाम्पल। व्हाट आर यू डूइंग माय सर? Indicate, sign of interrogation is there, WH word is there, no problem, you can easily understand it is interrogative sentence. In the same process, subject and object won't change, he will be he and me will be me, but sad too, simple sentence is there then that at all, but right now it is interrogative, then changing to ask. To remove commas won't change if or that. If WH word it is given, then it will be same. No need to use connectors. What will be what? Most important thing is that if sentence it is interrogative, so dear student, you just try to understand, we have to change into simple sentences. In direct sentence it is given interrogative, but it is our compulsion. When we will change in indirect, then we have to make it simple. How will you make simple? We know if sentence is interrogative, then we'll use helping verb always before subject. But if you will make it simple sentences, then first we will use subject, after that helping verb. So firstly we will take second person, it is given you, change according to object. Object it is me, then change into I. Now tense is present, outside is past, change into past. Is a mar change into was verb. With I will use was doing, my again first person, according to subject, subject it is he, then my change into his. For example, he, his, him, I, my, me. He change into I, he change into my, him change into me. Then it is my according to subject, it will be his. So dear student, these are interrogative sentence. But if sentence is interrogative, but there is no WH word, then we'll use if and whether. If and whether we'll use like that. If it is given like this. Are you doing my son? Now it is interrogative sentence, but there is no WH word. In such a condition we'll use if. To remove commas, if I was doing his, you try to understand, just it is an example so that you can understand. One more example. Ram said to me, Sima. सेम वे राम आस्क्ड सीमा टू रिमूव कॉमास डब्ल्यू एच वर्ड इज देयर यू अगेन सेकंड पर्सन अकॉर्डिंग टू सीमा देन सीमा विल यूज सी सी वाज गोइंग बिकॉज वाज इट इज प्रेजेंट आउटसाइड पास्ट then words. Some more example. What do you do my friend? Same way asked, what it is given, then what will be what? You second person according Sima. See, do does, you know, this do is helping verb and it is main verb. Do did done, it is helping verb. Helping verb is there, we know, we make it simple. Do does, simple present. Outside past, change it to simple past. Simple past will use second form. Then do second form. Did my first person according to Ram. Ram it is he. Then his. One more example. Teacher said to student, what is your name? Teacher said to student. Teacher and student, same subject and object, never change. Sad to change into ask comma remove comma will use what now is your name it is subject make it simple then firstly we'll use subject after that helping verb your it is second form second person according to student so student may be he or she whatever he and she oh sorry not he see your then according your her and his name is mr change into was what then his name was or her name was In the same way, one example more. How are you? Then how will be how? Firstly, we'll use you according to student. Then she or he. Watch. So student. Important thing is that if interrogative sentence is there, then firstly we'll use subject after that helping verb because it is necessary to make it simple sentence. interrogative sentence it is given, when will change into indirect, then we have to make it simple, then it will be correct. Okay, these are interrogative sentence. Now next class will discuss about imperative sentences. Thank you, have a nice day.